guys. I'm back. It's my 6 month update. And I've been trying to figure out how I was gonna do this, and I'ma just get right into it. Any questions or anything, please ask me at the end so I can answer everyone's questions. I'ma start off by saying when I started my surgery, I was 298 pounds. And today I am 225 pounds in 6 months. And I am very, 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 very happy with my results. Other people are losing weight really fast, a lot of weight. That's them, that's not me. My body is different from your body. Your body gonna be different from other people's body. So don't get discouraged if you don't lose a lot of weight at one time. People's head looks so big and the body looks so small and, you know, all these different things. And that's not everybody. So can't let that scare you away from getting a surgery. My regret is that I did not do it sooner. Do something about all of that weight sooner. Do something about the diabetes sooner. Do something about the high blood pressure sooner. I still live like a big girl. If I sit on the floor, when I get up, I always roll to get up. Even though I have lost over 70 pounds, I'm still rolling. I'm scared that I'm gonna hurt myself. I'm scared that I'm gonna hurt a bone or break a bone or something. Even though I don't have all that excess weight anymore, I still move like I'm a big girl. When I look in the mirror at myself, I don't see what other people see. Girl, you done lost so much weight. You look so good. To me, I always look good. Now, when I look at pictures before and after, I can see the big difference. My clothes size definitely show it, baby. Listen, Old Navy, size 14, almost in the 12 jeans. Oh, I ain't need that since I was 16, 17 years old, okay? Buying clothes, shopping as a smaller person is so hard. I feel like for smaller people, they have a lot of their back out, their stomach out. It shows a lot of their body. Like, it's all body, 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 body. And I never been the type of person that shows my body like that. Now, I do wear my tights. I love tights. Jeans is something new. I done brought me 3 pair of new jeans now, so I'm feeling these jeans. I always wore dresses, but now when I go to get me a dress, it's like a mini dress, basically. It's short, it's tight, you know. The first 3 months of the surgery went well. I mean, I did a lot of vomiting the first 3 months. My body would not accept certain food. And I get it. I just stayed away from it. Being that my stomach is so much smaller, air goes in, and then I'm trying to eat on top of that, that stuff comes back up. So that's why they want you to take Gassets or Tums or drink something warm before you eat. So that way, all the gas is off your stomach and your food can stay down. Once I learned that routine, I was good. Once I hit my 3 months, I promise you, no more vomiting at all. Now, what they call dumping, I dump. And I don't have an issue with dumping. Don't take dumping as a bad thing. That shit clean your ass out. So I brought me a smoothie from the Tropical Smoothie, and I forgot to tell them substitute sugar. And they use the regular sugar that they use. And I drunk it. I want to say 5 to 7 minutes after, I had to go to the bathroom. So you definitely gonna need you some baby wipes, wet naps, whatever. Because it ain't no, I'm gonna wait till I get home to use the bathroom. Or I can't use the bathroom in a public place. With this surgery, you don't got no choice. Because when it's ready to come, it's ready to come. Or you gonna shit on yourself. So you rather walk around shitty or you gonna go your ass in that bathroom, put that paper all around that seat and sit your ass down and take your dump and get the hell up out of there. The either or. Either gonna be shitty or you gonna go dump. And I ain't got no shame in my game. I'm going to the bathroom. You got to even be careful about passing gas. Because sometimes I be in the grocery store walking and I feel that gas coming. It just be a bunch of air come out. I mean, it be a long, long air. And sometimes that motherfucker be stank. I be praying nobody don't come down that aisle. I be praying nobody don't come to my desk. I be praying like, Lord, because that gas do not play. You're going to pass gas more than the average person. Because your stomach is so much smaller, so much more air, your air getting in there, that stuff got to come out. So you're going to pass gas way, way more. You're going to sometimes hear your food digesting, my stomach just talking. And it's not talking because it's hungry. It's working and I can hear it. They do ask you not to eat those starch, no rice, no bread, no noodles, no pasta. You know, stay away from all of that. Stick to your protein. Eat a little vegetable. They want you to eat first and then drink after. That way you get enough food in your body. The first time you go off that plan and you go get you some starch, you go get you a piece of bread, or you try you some rice, it ain't no turning back. I'm struggling with it right now. It ain't no turning back. I keep trying to do a reset, trying to get myself back on track, and that ain't happening. It's the hardest thing to do. Getting ready for this surgery was so easy. I was so excited, so determined, so ready. Now that I had the surgery, I have lost so much weight. Far as me getting back to stop eating starch, stop eating this, don't eat that, it is the hardest thing ever. First 3 months, I was on my vitamins heavy, taking my vitamins, taking my pills, doing everything I supposed to do. I mean, I was working out, I was going walking, I was determined because I had the surgery and I knew I'm finna lose this weight, I'm finna do this, I'm finna do that. After I realized that when I got on the scale, my scale was going up because I'm gaining muscles. Even though I'm still losing fat, muscles weigh more. So I say, let me stop working out. I'ma just lose and then go back to working out. Baby, it's been hard. And I got a gym where I live, and that's the hardest thing to do, is when I get off work, go to the gym now. Before, I wanted to go to the gym like crazy. I was motivated to go to the gym, ready, energized. Energy? These people thought my, oh, I got this much energy, I got that much. Where they getting it from? Because I can't find it. I don't have no energy for anything. When I get off of work at 5 and I drive home, I go straight to my bed. That's what I want. I want to see my bed. I don't want to see nobody. I don't want to talk to nobody. I don't want to go working out. I don't want to do any of that. I cannot find this energy. Everybody keeps saying they got so much energy now. Where are they getting it from? Because I can't find it. And I'm not the only one that can't find it. I have other people that I know that done did this surgery and they can't find the energy either. So I don't know if these people lying or what, but the energy, cannot find it. Now, could it be because I have not been taking my pills like I'm supposed to? It could be. So guess what? I done started back taking my pills. I ain't find it yet, but I'm back on my pills. I have my one-a-day prenatal pills. And these pills have every single thing your doctor tell you you need after the surgery. I'm telling you guys, you do not have to buy them bariatric pills. Those shits are freaking nasty. No matter which company you get it from, they're nasty. I got my calcium pills. Still taking calcium because sometimes when I get up, I feel crampy a little bit in my legs and my joints. So I just feel like I need to make sure I take my calcium pills. So with these two, it's all you guys really need after the surgery. I still eat small portions. My portions is not big. I can eat rice now. I do eat bread. If the doctor tell me that I can't eat no more starch, I don't know what I'm gonna do. That's the hardest thing to stay away from, starch. Man. I don't know what I'm gonna do if the doctor say I can't have no starch, honestly. ain't even finna lie to you. I don't know what I'm gonna do. Cause that is hard. I can no longer drink those protein shakes. Every time I drink a shake, it makes my stomach hurt really, really bad. Now, the doctors don't want you drinking alcohol anywhere from 6 months to a year. I'm at my 6 month. And it ain't like I had to have it now. Don't, you know, I ain't had to have it. But I had it. It didn't take much. I was feeling that thing. Woo! Stay away from the alcohol, though, because they really don't want you drinking alcohol. Okay, so I'm here. I'm mainly here for my arms today. I really want to do something about this, so we'll see how this consultation goes. So this is so far after the surgery. I need all this to be gone. I need these arms to be gone. Ooh, look at that rope back there. That need to go too. Get rid of that rope. Now, okay, you guys, I got on my gown. Now, I'm gonna be honest. Usually, I had to wear two gowns, one to the front, one to the back. But in this case, one gown is just good enough for me. How much money you talking? That's what I want to know. M-O-N-E-Y. How much money you talking and how good I'm going to look after all this money I'm spending? That's what I need to know. Stay tuned. Okay, so I'm very happy with what he told me we're going to do. We're going to get my arms and get me a breast lift. So these things going to be perky. Yes, y'all see that little curve coming already? It's coming. Don't worry. It's going to be here. But when he done, snatch your soul. Okay, so this girdle comes from Bloomingdale's. And this is the best girdle that I have found so far. TC. And I'm finna put the girdle on. Mind you, this is a small. This girdle does wonders for the bottom girdle to wear. I would say go in Bloomingdale's and get that girdle that they have until you're able to get your tummy tuck or whatever it is that you're trying. I also have the one that's made like panties. So you got the ones with the thighs and then you got the ones just made like panties. It lift your butt up so your butt don't be saggy. And it also hold you in the front.
So I'm at my 6 month and I'm still losing a lot of hair.
The last thing I wanted to talk about was this hair. With the surgery that I had, the gastric bypass, you lose a lot of stomach because your stomach is basically the size of a thumb. So with you losing so much stomach, you're not getting the nutritionist that you need. And being that you're not getting the nutrition that you need, all the protein you need, you lose a lot of hair. I lost a lot of hair. So my edges is gone. They gone. Far as the length, my hair's so broken. Some places long, some places short. I mean, it's broken real bad. We're talking about I had some good length and thickness all over. But now it's no longer like that. Now, my front was already a damage because I do the leave outs a lot. But, like, the back of my hair, it was not like this. Like, that surgery definitely messes with your hair. So keep that in mind when you get this surgery that you will be losing. I mean, you can drink as much protein as you want. I think because your stomach is so small, there's no way to avoid losing the hair. So I'm on my way now. I'm in Miami and I'm on my way now to go do get my hair done. And I usually do sew-ins.
But being that she got to braid my hair and sew it, it's a lot. It's a strain on my hair, so I'm not gonna do a sew-in. So I'm gonna get a bun in, and she's gonna put a cap on there, and I'm gonna wear bun in. I do not wear the wigs, no lace wigs or none of that. But I may have to start wearing them. My daughter wanna buy me one for my birthday, so I might have to start wearing wigs until my hair thicken back up. But yeah, so I'm gonna go and get my hair done, get something done to this head so I can look like somebody, and I get back with you guys. Coming back once my hair done so y'all can see how beautiful I look. Yeah, I'm getting my hair done by Dee Dee. Okay, people, so I just got my hair finished. I got me a short cut, and I'm looking cute, y'all.